We got snow here yesterday in the province of Canada. You just shovel a patch and you do some push-ups. Super simple. You can do it. You just gotta wanna do it. Turn the bass up! I got an S and I got a P. S stands for squat, P for push-ups. Each one of the flips represents the number of reps I'm gonna do of that exercise. I've already done this once. There wasn't any snow, but I'm gonna show you how to do it in the snow because, you know, that makes all the difference in the world. Last time I got 231 reps. It was heavy on the squat side because of the weight of the bottle cap. But that don't matter. We're gonna get the reps in. I'm gonna see if I can get more. That's all I'm gonna do. My timer for 10 minutes. We're gonna start flipping, start doing some push-ups, start doing some squats, and see how this goes. So before we begin, make sure you subscribe, hit the bell so you get updates on my future videos, and hit the thumbs up. Comment, make sure you share this with a friend. This bottle cap workout is a workout you can do anywhere. Push-ups and squats, you don't need no fancy gym. Just shovel a patch in your yard and away you go. There's a million YouTube videos on the internet where they show you how to do perfect push-ups. Keep your back straight, go down to the ground, push yourself back up, engage your abs, engage your butt, your legs, your shoulders, your triceps, and I think you'll do just fine, but the best way just to do the push-ups is just to do push-ups. You'll get better as you go along because you'll get stronger as you go along. As long as you're consistent, in my opinion, just get out there and do them. I enjoyed doing these little workouts here. The best part was the mix up between the push-ups and the squats. You never really knew what you were gonna get, kind of like a box of chocolates. When I was doing push-ups every day for 30 days, 100 to be exact, it was taking me 17 minutes to do the first 100, and then by the end of the 30 days I was doing 100 push-ups in just over 5 minutes. That's not close to the world record by any means, but it was definitely an improvement from where I once was. The whole part of this channel is to get myself up and moving, to shed the fat, to get stronger, to get more fit, so I can stick around on this planet for as long as I possibly can. And hopefully you get some benefit out of this too, because there's a lot of people out there that don't know how to get up off the couch and sit in their office chair. If you're sitting in an office chair right now, you should just stand up. And if you're already standing up right now, go ahead and sit down. And then stand up and sit down. Do that 5 or 10 times. There's nothing wrong standing up and sitting down. People do it all the time. Just if you do it consecutively, you know, controlled movement, relatively fast, you're gonna feel better. You're gonna burn a little calories, and maybe that's just a little bump that you need to get off the couch and get out of the chair and do something like this for real. Everyone has an excuse why they shouldn't get off the couch and go do a few push-ups or a few squats. Or what are your reasons to actually get up off the couch and do some push-ups or some squats? These crazy 10-minute workouts aren't meant to replace anything that you would probably do at the gym or going for runs or cycling or swimming or whatever you like to do. But it's to show you can burn a few extra calories anywhere you are in the middle of your day. Lunch break, recess, after school, between homework. There's really no excuse. In 10 minutes of high-intensity workout, boost your heart rate up and keep it up for a longer period of time. That means burning calories while you're just sitting around. raising your resting heart rate. And working out should be fun. You could be creative just like I am. Flipping a bottle cap, doing push-ups off of your car. Note the card at the top of this screen here right now. Yes, you can get a workout in anywhere. That card just proves it. Workouts don't have to be boring. You can use whatever you have around you. Practically anything. I could use that shovel that's in the screen, probably. Actually, I might just use a shovel in one of my next videos. And squats, those are an endless opportunity for variations. Jump squats, hack squats, put some weights on the back of your shoulders with a barbell, use kettlebells. You can use squats with kettlebell swings, front squats. I'm not really sure what that was that just flew by the camera. I didn't really even notice it until I started doing the voiceover. But if you know, leave a comment in the box below. I'd love to hear what you think. Even with doing all the little bit of squats that I've done in this video, I'm still quite winded at the end. And that has to do a lot with my diet. I don't eat too much junk food, but at the same time, I could definitely be controlling my portions. And I think that's where a lot of people get messed up. They're eating too much, even if it's a good thing. They say you can't eat too much of a good thing, but man, hummus is good for you. But I eat a ton of that, and next thing you know, packing on 20 pounds. You can't out-exercise a bad diet. That is the truest of all true things when it comes to the fitness world and health-related topics. You can't exercise and expect to get results when you keep eating and drinking. There's another one of my flaws, having drinks. And it's not even that I get drunk. It's that drinking, when you're drinking, you associate a lot of the fun times and the parties with food. There's always food when there's booze. They go hand in hand. You can't go anywhere without having booze and food. How many of these squats and push-ups did you do along with me? You can be serious. You can be honest. Leave your comments in the comment section below. I'd love to hear from you. I really would. Keep lifting, veg heads.
And that's the bottle cap workout. You can make a workout out of anything, anywhere. We got snow here yesterday in the province of Canada. You just shovel a patch and you do some push-ups. Super simple. You can do it. You just gotta want to do it. 10 minutes. It's the easiest way. Everybody's got 10 minutes. You got 10 minutes. I got 10 minutes. I just showed you 10 minutes. If I didn't have lentils cooking on the stove, probably do another 10 minutes. Next week, minutes on this bad boy. About 4 inches from the ground, 6x6, maybe 8x8. I don't carry a tape measure on me. We're just gonna show you how to do something on this bad boy. 10 minutes. Everybody's got 10 minutes. Start 2020 nice. You owe it to yourself. Keep lifting, veg heads. Make sure you subscribe, like, comment, share with your friends that need the push-ups.